Happy Monday, folks. A little sip for the day. Hey, so far, folks that are answering my contest, thank you so much. This is my first time. It took me forever because, again, it was something it's my nature, you know. When I do something, you know, I monitor it, you know. So it's taking up energy, but it's a good thing. I'm appreciating the folks that are answering because everyone has a record. See, it doesn't have to be something really strange or obscure because there are millions of releases. There's millions of records. And so everyone has a record in their record collection that it is less likely that a lot of other people have. And everyone has shown records I've never seen before, which I love. You know, also, some of them really get me going. Like Charlie, he showed that album by The Trip. That is so rare, man. I can't buy a copy for less than $100. That was a wonderful to see it, you know. Last time I saw a copy was in Japan for like $300, you know. So those are the kinds of things that pique my interest. Thank you for answering, and I hope that more people respond. Mr. Hall of Fame, Brandon, your response is very special to me and important to me. Thank you for talking a little bit about being black. I do think that you're right, that it's more of a generational thing about the bro thing, you know. And I think you're right. And it hasn't been everyone that's used the word bro that's bothered me, like elbow sausage. That doesn't bother me. It's been a couple of folks where it was their first comment to me ever, and in the comment was the word bro. As you said, Brandon, context is everything. If I don't know you, then I have to guess what the text is. And I never liked the term bro from the beginning, you know. Now, the way it evolved in the community, it sounds different than that bro shit, see. Bro sounds cheesy as fuck, you know. But when people start coming out and saying bruh, you know what I'm saying? You know, when it just falls out, that's different, okay? So, but these kind of discussions, I think, are valuable besides just talking about records. Talking about these social issues and encouraging people to have thoughts about them or to think at all is a good thing. So, thank you for sharing more of your experience and your thoughts, Brandon. I think it's very important. I want to add before I play a piece of music that I'm really into, and then I'm going to get off of here because I'm on a roll. I worked almost all day yesterday, and now I'm at the point of refining these pieces. You know, I started pieces that really excited me. Some people, their process is to drive and listen to the pieces. One of my processes is to go to bed and listen to the pieces because that's when you're kind of, how do you put it? It's like you can't escape the music, okay? It's like you're there, you're laying there, and whatever impression the music has on you is the one it really has. So I'll listen to it. This might be useful to some of you other artists. I'll listen to it before I go to bed to see how much of it I listen to before I fall asleep. That's one. And then when I'm waking up in the morning, before I'm ready to get up, I'll play it again. Because what's annoying about the piece is really annoying in that mind state. I bet you no one's ever shared that before. I wonder if many other artists have used that technique. Because that's when you really find, ugh, oh God, what was I thinking, you know? Because you're enslaved to the music. You know, you don't want to get out of bed and the music's playing and, you know, you don't even want to do anything but lay there. So I'm refining, but I've got eight new tracks. But the other social commentary I want to make is because I will put a word on myself if I have to define myself. A word that I'm comfortable with is radical. And it fits when I tell you what I'm going to say. Today is the inauguration of Obama. I'm not watching. I'm not fooled. Obama is a puppet. I was never fooled by his brown skin. He's a politician. He's a puppet. He is a He's a water boy. He has no power. The government, now, again, some of you folks will probably think I'm crazy, and that's fine, because I know, and it's like, that's why I have this, I have an informed opinion. But the government is just, it's a prop. It's like a storefront, you know, run shit, you know what I'm saying? And they definitely don't represent us as people. And I never for a moment thought that the fact that they could get a brown-skinned man, a black man for president, was going to mean anything to anyone that's awake like me. I saw it from the beginning. This is smoke, more smoke and mirrors. It means nothing, you know. Ain't nothing anyone can tell me to make me go back and believe in false hope. Folks, you know, our future's been sold down the river, and everything that we're doing is just to keep doing it, folks. But, you know, the inauguration of President Barack Obama has no meaning to me. None. I was so done with the lie of the world before he became president that I couldn't even get excited like people all around me. All of my white friends, you know, couldn't understand, and my black friends couldn't understand, and I watch and listen now, and everything I hear, it's a lie, it's a lie, it's a lie, okay? So I want to put that out there. I'm a radical. I don't believe none of this bullshit. I'm just trying to enjoy my life until I die. That's all I'm doing. I have no false hope for the future of this country, this world. The idea of the one world government and all that sort of thing, where the average person dismisses it because it's, you know, it just seems so ludicrous. Ain't nothing ludicrous about it. It's going on. And I have been around money. I've been around money, and that's why I have this position, especially about race, because I've been around money. I've been friends with people with money, gone to situations where I'm a guest, but the people who don't know me, I may as well be the help. You know what I'm saying? Time and time again, I'm not fooled, okay? I just want to play a little bit. Catherine Wheel is one of the, you know, seems like shoegaze is trying to make a comeback in the media. Somebody's trying to put it back. You know how they recycle things? Shoegaze has been coming up in the media. And, of course, they always bring up the main ones, Ride, My Bloody Valentine, Slow Dive. Those are great bands. The Verve. Thankfully, last night on NPR Sound Opinions, they mentioned Loop. Someone also mentioned Catherine Wheel. And I think it's criminal that Catherine Wheel is not better recognized. I think it's because they're so good. You know, it's like, it's not average. It's not mediocre. You got to have something in order to hear this music. I'll say it. I don't mean to insult people. I'm just saying it like it is. You know, that's why the rich man has it over us, is because they use their smarts. And they've used their smarts to make sure that everybody else is pretty dumb, too. How's that? And so consequently, some of the best music, which takes something to get a lot of people, and it's just reality, okay? A lot of dumb, ignorant ass people in this world, okay? Ain't nothing cool about it. And they're the ones breeding. But here we, okay, stop, Derek. I thought of this too because of Brandon. I remember you bought this. It was an exchange we had, and you found a copy. So, Catherine Wheel, love this band. This is off of their first album, Ferment. It's again that beat. I met these guys, that drummer. Bad motherfucker. That sublime of what? Come on, people. Oh, was listening to Ride recently too. Carnival Life. Alright, that's enough for today, guys. Love you much. Enter my contest.